All right, hello everyone. Peace of Christ to all. I wasn't really planning to open right now. I was posting and answering some Muslims and Abduls in a forum. It's called TED.com. Actually, you see it with me in the screen right now. Now, TED,
in a forum, it's called
TED.com. Sorry, my voice is coming again. So somebody sent me this this video and said to me, look what they have there, and they are talking about how this woman, she lost her family in USA, and supposedly this is about hero crime. And as you see in the title, it says Islamophobia killed my brother, let us end the hate. And actually I was planning to make a broadcast tomorrow, but tomorrow we'll make it about our chat room maybe. So let us Islamophobia killed my brother, let us end the hate. And you know, those liberals, they are inviting Muslims and putting them in the stage, and in a second, everybody, if you read the comments of those people who they are commenting there, many of them, they are Christians. And you know, I'm not allowed based in the Bible to call Christians stupid, but excuse me Lord, I have to call them stupid. Look how easy Muslims, they can fool the Christians and make them believe that really there is something is called Islamophobia. If you see the comment here, and by the way, I'm doing my video today because I post my comment too, but guess what, my comments removed in the speed of light in less than 9 minutes. After I posted my comments, I received an email saying your comment be removed. Your comments be removed, you know. And it took me actually 15 minutes just to log in, just to make, because this, for some reason they could not take my account and activate it. So it took me 15 minutes just to make the account, and then I'm refuting all those who they are posting there, including Muslims. And then I receive an email from this website who claim, like if you go to this website, it's about us. They say to you that we are you know, we are organization who like to teach the truth. Our mission is to spread ideas. TED is a global community welcoming people from every discipline and culture who seek deeper understanding of the world. We believe, as you see, you know, like you can read the rest of it. But the second I post my comment, secondly, it's not everybody is welcome. It's only those who agree with them. Do you see the hypocrisy? They speak about democracy, and you know, you are welcome to make your own statement. You are welcome to say your mind. You are welcome, as long as you are not teaching hate. I do not teach hate. I just posted. I had the comment, actually. I'm going to show you my email, because they sent me the email saying to me your comments is removed. So you can see exactly what I posted, and you tell me if there's something wrong I said. Those people, they are the most disgusting creatures ever. They cannot take the truth for a second. And this is how weak they are. Because if they are not weak, you see, if you go to my YouTube, if you go to YouTube, you will see Muslims calling me all kinds of names and sending me all kinds of things. You lie, you said this, and they suppose they will refute me. I don't take their post off. I don't. Why want to take it off? You take it off unless somebody is using the F-word, and even those who use the F-word, I let it go. They could not take my comment because they can't answer me. This is the email I received. This is my email. I hope you can see it clear on the screen. As you see in the front of your eyes, it says, your email, dear Christian Prince. This is the account I made there under the name of Christian Prince. Let me make the text bigger so you guys can read it with me. All right. So dear Christian friends, your comment full text below has been removed according to our TED.com terms of use. For God's sake, read with me my comment. Tell me what's wrong I said. Just tell me what's wrong. What is the problem? There is a problem here. I cannot see it. What I did exactly is bad. If you see with me here, and I'm going to read with you my comments, so all of you can read with me. I hope my screen is coming to you perfectly, and you guys, you can see it. You have no problem with seeing it and reading it. This is my full text as it is, and this is an email, remember, I received from them as it is, all right? No editing, as it is. Full text, Islam is amazing belief. This is my word now. But yet they love us too much, the point Allah forbid them from offending us. You see the woman in this video here, she is giving us a speech about what happened to her brother. What happened to her brother is very simple. He have a fight over a parking with someone. Obviously, he's a crazy man. He shot him dead. But those Muslims, they try to invest in everything that happened to them to make it about Islam. The whole fight is about the parking lot. They make it as a hate crime. However, let us say for the sake of argument, it's a hate crime. How many hate crime caused the death of Muslims last year in America? And how many hate crime made by Muslims caused the death of non-Muslims in America just last year? Let us count Muslims. And then we can decide who is the one have a phobia. In one attack, in just one attack, you killed more than 100 people. One attack in one day. When the guy he attacked, the beautiful, peaceful Muslim guy who attacked a gay club. What about the guy who attacked with his wife? His wife, even his wife is a member of terrorism. And he starts shooting people who he worked with. People who invited him for a party. Who is the one have a phobia? This is just two attacks, can count for tens of people get killed. And yet, one case of fighting over a parking spot have nothing to do with religion. They were not talking about religion. And the guy even is an atheist, which means he don't give a damn for God or anything is called religion. The one who shot this Muslim is an atheist. They make it as about a phobia, about Islamophobia. And she speak about her beautiful brother. Let us end the hate. I want to end the hate. For God's sake, let us end the hate, Muslims. How many right now in this second, in this moment, is being beheaded because of the hate of Islam? How many women this moment, this second, is being raped because of the hate of Islam? And how many people get killed because of the Islamophobia this moment? Why everything is upside down? What Islamophobia mean? I mean, seriously, what Islamophobia mean? Phobia is you being scared of something is not real. Is the killing of Muslims is real? Is the bloodshed of non-Muslims done by Muslims is real? Like, are you watching the news? Just in the last week, just the last week only, in Germany alone, more than 5 Germans get killed. Just yesterday, I heard the news. A woman and a boy, they got killed, slaughtered by a knife, by a Muslim attack. That's only in just little. And those people who took you home, those people who gave you home, those people who gave you shelter, you killed them. Who is the one who have a phobia? Until now, people in Paris, they are crying for the crimes is done by the name of Allah. Who is the one who have the phobia? Do you see a French person who have a phobia driving his car or his truck into hundreds of Muslims trying to smash them alive? Let us say there's somebody have a phobia. Where are they? And what phobia is doing? When the whole story of phobia is nothing but a fabrication created by the left sponsored by the Muslims because they like the idea. The left is the one who starts using the term Islamophobia. The fact you people are the one who is full of phobia. If a Muslim, you eat next to him pork, he get upset. In the stupid Europe, they are taking crosses from the street, from the school, the Bibles, from the school, because now we have a Muslim refugee. We don't want to offend them. Who is the one who have the phobia? You disgusting liberals, you are really seriously disgusting. Who is the one is sick with the phobia? I want to know. The Muslims, they pray to their God 5 times a day. The first thing they do in the morning, they curse the Christians and the Jews. Go and read a chapter of Al-Fatiha, which is where they say in the last verse in that chapter, Allah don't make us the same as the Christians, the lost Christians or the cursed Jews. The first thing in the morning, they have to insult us before even they eat. Who is the one who have the phobia? And this is my comment in Gmail. Islam is a beautiful religion. She is giving us speeches about love, but she is wearing hijab. And someone wearing hijab, it's me religious. A religious mean he believe in every word written in his book and every word his prophet he taught. This is what wearing hijab mean. Otherwise, I don't see a meaning to telling me about Islamophobia if you don't believe in Islam. Like there's one of the idiots in the comment there. Look what he said. Let me show you. And actually, I made a response to him, but they removed my comment immediately. Just let me review the comment. Sony Sharama or Shamara, whatever his name, maybe it's a woman. I am a Christian and very saddened by Islamophobia. No matter what gender, sexuality, religion, or race should be discriminated against. Thank you for your talk. Do those people know what they are talking about? As long as you believe in this, you should say to her, well, you are a person who believe in discrimination. And you are giving us a lecturer about discrimination. Do you know right now in Saudi Arabia, there is no go zone? No go zone. There is highway for Muslims and there is highway for non-Muslims. Which means if you are a Muslim, you can take a certain highway, and if you are non-Muslim, you have to take your own road. Otherwise, if you take the wrong road with Muslims, you will be slaughtered. It's hard to believe, right? Like I remember when somebody spoke, I think in Fox News or something like this, about no-go zone in France. The media, they start making fun of them and no-go zone, ah, ha, 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 and actors and those liberals, ha, 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 phobia. The no-go zone is reality, my friend, in Islam. You see, they say it's disgusting that the white men in South Africa used to separate the white and the black in the buses. And even maybe this was done one day in America. And I believe this is very disgusting too. But until now and forever, the Muslim will practice this in Saudi Arabia. And not even single idiot dare to say why. Not even single idiot of them, he dare to say, where is the human rights? I don't see it. Why we don't see those people who they stand in TED talk show speaking about why this religion is discriminating Christians and Hindus and Buddhas and whoever they are for a very simple reason, just because they are non-Muslims. You can go and search yourself. You know, I'm going to show you some pictures here just to show you we are not making things up. As you see, for non-Muslim Muslims, the street, there is signs everywhere in the street. This is not one sign, not two sign, not three sign, not five signs. They are all over and they are not ashamed of them. Streets for Muslims, street for non-Muslims. Is that because of love or this is because of hate? Do you know why we have streets for our own? And you will see it says in red, non-Muslims. Why we are in red? Because we are the dirty one. Green, it's mean you are safe. But if non-Muslim, he enter the green zone, he will be killed. He will be slaughtered. Speak about discrimination. I encourage you. I would like to see those people speak against discrimination. It is legal, it's official, and you filthy people never speak about it. Imagine in New York we have a highway for Muslims only because they are dirty. As the Muslim, they claim that we are. Imagine we say only for Muslims. And if you enter the greenway, which is for non-Muslims, then you'll be killed. What the liberals will do? Wow. And then they give me a woman wearing hijab, her brother killed over a fighting in the parking lot to speak about Islamophobia. And by the way, the picture you see in the screen in front of your eyes, this is coming from the Quran. This is because they might say to you, remember, the Muslims, they are very professional in lying and they know how to fool you. Because obviously they learned that in this West, there's a lot of dumb, stupid people. And this is true. They might try to fool you, say, this is have nothing to do with Islam. Are you sure? Yes, my friend. This is have nothing to do with Islam. Islam is not about this. Islam doesn't teach that. This is a culture. This is non-Islamic. This is extremist. The fact all of this is in the Quran. The Quran says وَإِنَّمَا الْمُشْرِكُونَ نَجِسْ وَإِنَّمَا what? الْمُشْرِكُونَ نَجِسْ. What does that mean? Anyone who don't believe in Allah is a dirty, filthy, like a sewage. And based on this, they are not allowed to enter a holy area like Mecca or Al-Madinah. And this can be found in chapter 9, verse number 28. This is not a culture. And this is not a Christian prince made. This exists in the teaching of their filthy, disgusting, hateful book which teach discrimination. Imagine we make a speech right now saying that if you are not a Christian, you are dirty. And you are filthy. And you should not be allowed to enter our street. The Muslim, they practice it right now in the year 2016. And they don't want you to talk about it. Oh, who you believe? Truly the pagans are unclean. By the way, the word unclean here is absolutely false translation. Any clean here is not really fit with the meaning. The word najis is not even about any clean. It's like you are the most filthy. Like if you marinate someone in the sewage for 10 years and you take him out, then you call him najis. Najis means there's nothing can clean him. It's not someone he can take a shower and get clean. No, he is najis. It means even his blood is dirty. Even his flesh is dirty. It doesn't matter. You take a shower or not, you are najis. And when I start posting in the comment section in this website, after 9 minutes, I said to myself, maybe it's going to take a year before I lose it. Or maybe a week. Maybe a day. It's not even 9 minutes. They send me the email saying your email, your post is removed. And if you read to me, if you read with me this removed email, I don't see anything. I thought, you know, like, look, Allah, He loves us to the point He forbid Muslims from befriending us. Am I lying? Am I pause the verse, chapter 5, verse 51. Allah saying in the Quran, oh, the Muslims, take not the Christians and the Jews as a friends. That's it. I did not say anything. And then he said, Islam is all about peace. And here is the proof. And I said, from the deception of Allah, book of the teaching of Muhammad, you are the best of people never raised up for the ever raised for the benefit of mankind. Chapter 3, verse 1 to 110. The best of mankind is those whom bring them with chains around their necks till they embrace Islam. And I paused the hadith number. Well, what I did, I just quote the Quran, I just quote the hadith, I just quote what Muhammad said, what his companion they said. I'm not the one saying that. Why you remove my comment? Aren't you asking people to come and share education? And then I continue saying, and look how amazing the God, amazing Muhammad, her God, because the fact Muhammad is a true God for Muslims. He attacked peaceful tribe just while they are doing nothing but, you know, like they are watering their animals, etc. You know, and I posed the story when he attacked Bani Mustaliq and he killed all the men and he stole all the women, he kidnapped them and he raped them all. And he took all their animals and their wealth for no reason. Just because they don't want to be Muslims. And then I said, 99% of the total killing in the world today is done by Muslims. And because of their hate. Yet you want to make me feel guilty for a fight over a parking? Why, you know, there's people they fight over parking every day somewhere. There's everywhere people, they shoot people everywhere. What this have to do with hate crime? Did you hear the guy when he shot your prophet, your brother saying Allahu Akbar? Or atheist Akbar? Or Jesus Akbar? It's you Muslims who do that. And then I post another comment. They remove it too. There's a Muslim guy, he was posting there saying people don't understand that Islam has nothing to do with this. So I gave him to this. I gave him this. Listen, I said his name is Jihad. The funny, his name is Jihad, and he's talking about Islam has nothing to do with this. Isn't it funny? His name, this Abdul, is Jihad. Let me show you the comment. Let me see where his name. Here we go. I posted to this guy. Hello, Le Pen. I think the reason why you are seeing this a lot of bad news about Muslims because the media wants to make the focus about Muslims' mass behavior. It has no relationship with believing Islam. Like what? It doesn't? And his name is Jihad. And Jihad is about fight to kill. And for sure they will say to you, Jihad has many meaning. Yes, Jihad has many meaning. What are Muslims, when a Muslim speak about Jihad, everyone knows that Jihad is about fight to kill. For this is the best Jihad. This is a Muslim Abdul. A sheikh. You see his beard? I mean, come on, look at this beard. A woman, she's asking, my husband, he wanna do jihad. So what he say about jihad? Did he understand jihad is about fasting? No. Did he, like, why he did not take it wrongly? I mean, the woman, she just said, my husband wanna do jihad. Why he did not think, why he did not ask her, do you mean fasting or you mean maybe he don't want to, he want to pray more, because they give you other meaning, right? But look, nobody thought of other meaning. Right away he speak about fighting and killing. But the woman, she just did one word. Now, for sure, the woman, she did not talk here because she's not allowed. You know, the question coming as a text.
Add physically in Syria, though husband wants to go to jihad physically in Syria, though, mashallah, they give a lot of money and they give sadaqah and so on. He wants to go physically for jihad. And this is a dilemma. See, jihad is one of the greatest deeds you could ever do. And each and every individual has this urge in him. Otherwise, he would be labeled as a hypocrite. The Prophet ﷺ said that who does not fight in jihad and does not talk to himself about it, meaning that inshallah next year, inshallah the following year, then if he dies, he would die on a branch of hypocrisy.
Did you hear it? Did you hear it? If you don't fight, not if you don't do peace. He didn't say, the Prophet said, if you don't do peace, it's mean you are a hypocrite. He said the one who don't do jihad is a hypocrite. The Muslim who do not do jihad is a hypocrite man officially. And this is a statement coming from the mouth of their prophet. And we just heard their scumbag sheikh saying that. So where is the peace and where is the love? And you are talking about somebody killing your brother over a parking lot? When you are teaching your children that it's your duty during your lifetime to go and kill somebody or as many as you can just to make this filthy God, blood-loving God, vampire, happy. How we can make this God happy? By doing jihad. And you don't do jihad, you are a filthy hypocrite. Allah, he hate you. Therefore, you will not go to heaven. It's a duty for every Muslim during his lifetime at least to go to do jihad for some time. Why they get upset when we say the truth? Yesterday, I was talking to a friend, and I told that friend, I'm really sick of everything around me. Because everything is wrong. Look out our videos. We make a great videos. I spend a lot of time from my time to help people, to answer people, to give them the reference, etc. And then we have 1,000 viewers. A fake speech made by this woman have more than 500,000 viewers. Half million. Do you see it? $542,000 viewer. When everything she said there is a lie. This is how disgusting this world is. The more you speak the truth, the more people they ignore you. The more hypocrite you are, the more people they will view you. You know, we ask people to share our videos. Nobody cares. They go, you know, like they, in the maximum, they say to you, thank you in the text and they leave. Like this isn't the best scenario. Like even comment, they are cheap to post a comment. But a woman, she is saying nothing but a bunch of lies. Look how many comments there are. Unbelievable. And all the comments are supporting, Christians are supporting, Christians are crying for her. Like, we, our heart for you, my friend. We are so sad for you. For sure, you know, nobody is happy for her brother to be killed. But there is a criminals everywhere, and those have nothing to do what they are trying to make it it's about. You remember our argument here is not about we are taking the side of the guy who killed her brother. Absolutely, this is false. This guy is an idiot. He deserves to go to jail for the rest of his life and even execution. I will not be sad, actually, if they execute this guy who killed this guy over a parking lot. For obviously, he is a criminal. That is not a topic. everything around you, making you question sometime, where is, what's wrong with people? What's wrong? Sometimes it makes you feel like you are, you belong to somewhere else. You don't belong to this earth. I never said something or posted something is not there. Everything I say, everything I do, I give proofs, I give reference. I don't speak for my own. And actually, I'm more upset from the Christians, because obviously, if you go and see the comments there, you will see a lot of them, they are Christians, naive Christians. That's me, we Christians, we are not doing a good job. That's me, we are Christians by names. We have no education, we are ignorant. Why such a woman is allowed to deceive our fellow Christians? Who is the one that is allowing her? You know, I'm not surprised from atheists or those liberals who put her on the stage. They are from the same scam. They belong to the same garbage. When I say garbage, I mean garbage, because garbage is about deceiving. If you are truthful, let us speak too. What about you invite me and you invite her? Let us see. Let people judge. Why it's one-sided view? Anything you say, anything they say, you know, they can flip it about upside down just to make it so nobody listening. Like this guy is a fascist, maybe he's a Nazi, maybe he's working for Hitler, maybe he is, etc. But the fact, they are the fascist. It's a fascism that you take only one side and you don't allow to show the other side of the coin. That is fascism. It's fascism that I post a comment and I said nothing wrong there, except giving proofs and reference for every word I'm saying. And then you take my statement and you throw it in the garbage just because you don't agree with it. That is fascism. Is to believe that you are always right without even listening to the other person, giving him a chance even to give a proof of what he is claiming to, even if it's not true. You see, when we debate Muslims, we open our chat rooms and we invite Muslims to come and we give them chance to say whatever they want, and here we go, prove me wrong. Very, very, very disgusting. And I want the Christians to listen carefully. What's happening around you because of you Christians, because of your false churches, who they are not doing their jobs. Those churches where people, they go just to wave their hands to Jesus, but nobody do anything to Jesus. Nobody want to serve Jesus. Those are not churches. Those are social club. In those churches, there is no service for Jesus. Those who believe in Jesus is the one who stand the way the Lord he stand. If you are a person who believe in being politically correct, you are no Christian. You are a false, false, false Christian. Jesus will say to you, stay away from me, Satan, devil. For you have no courage to say what Jesus said. If you are ashamed of what Jesus said, get out, get out of his holy home, and don't ever claim to be Christian. If you don't have the courage to say the truth, so who are you? What is left of you? A human being, a garbage bag, we put food inside and then the food comes from the other direction in a toilet seat? What is left? I mean, what is the meaning of our existence if we cannot say our mind? If we cannot say or believe? What are we? Are we worms who go in the ground and we suck the mud and then we poop the mud from the other side? Is that how we are? They want you to be a worm. And all worms have to swim in one direction. And we are not worms. And we will not be. It doesn't matter. You see, when I complain, I say it's really disgusting. I will never give up, and I will never say, you know what, look like maybe I'm the only one is fighting in this war alone. I don't care. Honest to God, even if there is one person, his name is a Christian prince, between 7 billion human beings, they don't dare to say the truth, I will say the truth. I don't care. I don't want to live as a worm and die as a worm. If you think you are created for a reasons of eating and doing poo-poo, you are mistaken, my friend. In this case, you are nothing but a chicken. Today you eat the chicken, tomorrow the earth will eat you. And your body will be eaten by the earth. And the worms will eat you. The same you eat the chicken, remember that. Tomorrow you will be a food of different creature. And it's going to happen, you like it or not. Even if they burn your body, as some people they think, if they burn your body, became ashes, nobody will eat you. You are mistaken. You are badly mistaken, my friend. You are going to turn a food for somebody else. Your body is destroyed. But if you are with the truth, your spirit will live forever. Nothing is better joy in this earth or in heaven than being truthful. And if we lost our ability to be truthful, there is no reason for us to be around. Tomorrow we will have our chat room is going to be open. I would like to have everybody with us, and we will do live podcast. But really, I want to see Christians helping us in what we do. I keep saying, please invite us to your churches. If you cannot invite us to your church, what about we organize? What about we organize and we found a space and we invite people to attend? My friends, if we don't do something, something will be done to us. Look around you. Not long time ago, everybody used to be different. And not long time after, they start taking the Bible from the drawer of the hotel, the cross from the park. You cannot place any religious, you know, when this country was always a Christian and all those countries was always a Christian, suddenly we should deny to be Christians just to satisfy those filthy idiots who don't believe in Christianity. We don't care, you know, we don't force you, you know, if you are a pagan, place your pagan god there. You don't worship what? You worship your private part? You are placing your private part. How come they have a naked beach? Naked beach is fine, but we cannot place a cross in the street. Naked men and naked women walking in the beach is fine, showing their ugly private and wearing the flag of America is a shame. That's happening because we are not there. And you know, we prayed to God, and I said to myself, if Trump he won, is going to be a miracle, because this country was doomed, badly doomed. I'm very thankful that at least Trump, he will not be the same as the rest, but I'm not expecting too much. But he will not be the same as they are, for sure. But this is not enough. We need a revolution. We need a movement. Invite me. Speak to people around you. I don't care how it is. A church, not a church, doesn't matter. Let me come. I come in the prison. Some people, they think I am hiding my face. I am not hiding my face. I'm not worried about my security. Trust me, this is not my issue. I don't like it. I don't like to be public with my face. Otherwise, I will put my face right now in the camera and scare the hell of you. But I don't like to be famous. I'm not here doing a job to be famous. Me. It's not about me. None of you knows even my real name. I will come. I will speak in public. And I did that in many, many, many places. Help us. Look at them. They have almost 1,000 people listening to this woman in the stage. Why they can do something like that and we cannot do something like them? Isn't it a shame? What is missing? I don't really understand. What is missing? I believe they're missing that we don't have the real will to make things happen. And look how many Muslims they are inviting to this what they call it TV show. Look like here we go, the other one. I think here I did not have it. There is a video actually. I encourage people to watch it. It's called Undercover Mosque Dispatch. I don't know if you guys heard of it.
Tonight on Dispatches, an ideology of bigotry and intolerance spreading through Britain with its roots in Saudi Arabia.
We Muslims have been ordered to do brainwashing
on women's rights.
Allah has created for women nutrition.
If she doesn't wear hijab, we hit her.
Gay rights.
Take the homosexual man and throw him off the mountain.
Living in a multicultural society.
This is what they teach in the mosque. And imagine, this is done by the BBC. Oh, I think, not the BBC, I think Channel 4 in England. And right away, after 1 week, they forced them to make it disappear from the internet. And what you see right now is not really posted by the TV. They chase anyone who posts this video, trying to hide it. They force the TV station to shut it down and to hide it. This is an investigation, real investigation done by liberals who don't believe us. Showing you what they teach in your mosque in the West. And this is specifically, you know, in England. But the fact, there's many of the faces you saw on the screen, they are American convert. So this is not only in England, this is all over the West. Kill non-Muslims, beat the women, kill the homosexual, all kind of teaching. This is inside their mosque. But when they stand in the front of us in the stage, they have different tone, different voice, different words, different value. I encourage you, all of you, to go and search this video. And again, it's called Undercover Mosque Dispatch. Actually, let me post the link for you in the text, in the chat. So you guys, you can download it. And save it with your friends. Share it. This is, they are nothing but truth. It's not a Christian prince saying that to you. It is Muslim from their mouth, what they teach inside the mosque, behind closed doors. But yet, those liberals, they invite someone to fool you in the stage, say to you, Islam is a wonderful religion, and let us end the hate as if we ask the one who teach the hate. Isn't it our Lord, the Messiah, who said, love your enemy? Have you ever seen someone saying, in the name of Jesus, I'm cutting your throat? I can show you tons, thousands of videos made by Muslims about slaughtering and encouraging Muslims to slaughter. And not to forget to mention the Quran and the Hadith and the act of Muhammad. Like, who is the best example for the Muslims? Muhammad. Muhammad was the biggest criminal, rapist, filthy creature ever, human race ever known. If this is the best example, what about the worst? Sometimes ask yourself, name for me one thing filthy Muhammad did not do. Muhammad, he said, my cousins, they raped him. So he was raped, according to him. He raped a child. He had sex with animal. He had sex with men. He used to suck and lick the tongues of boys. He was a thief. He raped women. He kidnapped women from their houses. He killed men. He steal, even the Muslims, they accuse him of stealing an underwear. I mean, name for me one thing Muhammad in his life wasn't about a crime. All his life is a series of crimes. There's a story, it's called 1000 Night, 1001 Night, I think. I don't know what they call it in English. But this is a very old legend. We can make from the stories of Muhammad 1001 Night book. All of it is about rape and killing and attacking. Anyway, I don't want to spend too much time with you from your time, guys. I just wanted to share this with you, showing you how filthy those people are. Who we didn't, you know, we just post a comment and instead your comment, they will not get it, go through. And this is why I make videos, and I encourage you to download my videos, to save them, spread them, put them in your page, Facebook, in your YouTube. I don't care. I don't care if you have more subscribers than me. I'm not working for myself. All of us, we are serving the Lord. I'm not like some names who they don't allow you to post their video because you will take subscribers from their names. I don't care. Take all my subscribers. That is the last of my worry. We want as many as we can people to learn. If there's anyone have a question, please let me know. Do we have any question in the chat speaking there? Any Abdul there? I don't know if we have any Abdul, but maybe we don't. I want to say thank you for listening. Please don't forget to subscribe and ask your friend to join our YouTube and to share our videos. And in case anyone have a questions, feel free to contact me. And tomorrow we will try to open our chat room and do live broadcast again. Aban is Abdul. Well, Aban, how are you doing, Aban? Why the Muslims, they come in the chat and they try to prove their point in the chat, but they don't dare to debate me? How come? Imagine we open our chat room for not 1 hour. Everyone know of you. I stay in Facebook, sorry, in YouTube, doing my video for 8 hours non-stop, right? But this is not the whole story, actually. This is the maximum YouTube gave me. But the fact I stay longer, we stay 10 hours, 12 hours, and still we don't see the Abdul's there to come and try to debate us and answer us. But in text, they debate themselves. They answer themselves and they win. There's nobody there. And in text, even if you answer him, by the way, even if you, let us say, you give him the answer he's looking for, still he did not hear you. He did not see you. Where is the answer? You did not answer me. I want to see real Muslims coming to debate us, having courage and knowledge, and you are more than welcome. Don't worry, you know, we are going to treat you very nice. But as I understand, they don't come to debate and answer because they knew they cannot make it. I want to show you one more thing from Facebook. This is Abdul from Facebook. Let me show you the Abdul page. This is Abdul in Facebook. He posted this. He said, a Christian, you will have to pay for your sin, not Jesus. And then he posted verses from the Bible. Let me show you that, show the Abdul how stupid they are, because obviously they never get it. When we Christian, we say that Jesus, he paid for our sin, doesn't mean that Christians cannot go to hellfire and never enter heaven. Doesn't mean that we have a free license for sin, you stupid idiot. When we say Jesus, he paid for our sin, it doesn't mean that I can go and kill and rape and steal because Jesus paid for my sin. This is not what we mean by saying that. What we mean is very simple. But because of our sin, Jesus, he paid a price which was his life and his suffer because of our sin. So he paid for our sin, but doesn't mean that we have a free license to sin. The stupid Abdul, they think because they hear the Christians saying that Jesus, he paid for our sin, they think because of that, that we as a Christians, we can go and have, you know, do whatever we want. We spend the whole day making party, having cocaine and heroin, molesting children, maybe like their prophet, kidnapping women from their houses like their prophet, raping the wife of their son like their prophet. We cannot do any of that. Jesus said, not everyone says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of my Father, but the one who do his will. So what the condition is to do his will is not to say Jesus, Jesus. Is not to say Lord, Lord. Did you get it, Abdul? In the same time, I paused for him this Abdul. I hope my text is clear. I'm not sure. Let me make it bigger. So you guys can read better. Let us see. All right. I said to him, not sure, Abdul, who told you that this, you know, we Christian, when we say that Jesus paid for our sin, doesn't that mean we have a license to sin? And I posted for him a list of the hadith where he's a prophet. He said that in the day of resurrection, Allah will take the sin of the Christians and of the Muslims, and he place it on the sin on the Christians. So it is you Muslims who believe that someone else will pay for your sin, and it is unjustified. It is the stupid religion of Islam is the one who teach that someone else will pay for your sin, not the Christians. We Christians don't believe in that. Everyone will pay for his sin. And we will not go even to heaven if we live the life of sin. Who said that we are going to go to heaven because we are in love with sin? This is not how heaven is going to be given to us. Jesus, he gave us a promise. Whoever believes in me and die, he will live. But in order to believe in him is to follow him. In order to follow him is to walk the steps he walked. You say, you talk, and you walk the talk. This is why not everyone says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of my Father, but the one who do his will, doing his will. And doing his will is fighting sin, not to be in love with sin. In Islam is the opposite. Look what your prophet is saying. The logic of your God, the hateful God, that in the judgment day, Allah will take, and imagine, guys, even the hadith number is weird. I mean, seriously, do you see with me in the screen? Do you see with me in the screen? Sahih Muslim, hadith number 6666. Do you see it? I mean, that's alone is like, it's really like, I don't know what to say. Even the hadith number is alarming. Allah's messenger said, there would come people amongst the Muslims in the day of resurrection with as heavy sin as mountain, and Allah would forgive them, and he would place their sin instead on the Jews and the Christians. Do you see it? In the hadith number 6666 and 6667 and 6668. Or the hadith above it, 666, as you see it. And yet the Muslim, he don't believe that somebody can pay for the sin of somebody. But yet the stupid ones, they themselves, they believe in that. I mean, seriously, do you see how stupid those people are? It is you, Abdul, who believe in somebody will pay for your sin. And this is the teaching of your prophet. And now he posted a new post. Let me see what he said. Islam for dummies, education and debate, etc. Chapter 5, verse number 65. And if only people of the scriptures, Jews and the Christians, have believed in Muhammad and word of evil, etc., etc., etc. You see how stupid they are. Let us say this post, he's posting that the Christian, they do not believe and they are bad. Still, what is the reason to place the sin of somebody in somebody else? Where is justice? Just to show you that Muslims are donkeys, they have no brain. They have no brain. Let us say for the sake of argument, the Christians are drug dealers, are criminals. Their women are prostitutes. Their fathers are they do sorcery. Their mothers are crazy. You know you name it. Give me a reason and under what justification that somebody have to pay for the sin of somebody. And the funny, the Quran itself said that nobody should pay for the sin of his father or the sin of other person. But look, the hadith teach the opposite. And look how stupid the answer. What is the answer? He was talking about sin. He wanna tell me that we Christians don't think that Jesus will pay for your sin, right? And look, when I put him in the corner, look what he answered me. What is the answer? What does this have to do with this? What does this have to do with this? You are admitting, your prophet admitting that Muslims, they have sin. And they're sin like mountains. Sin like mountains. So why even people who have sin like mountains, they will go to heaven? Muslims, who paid for their sin? You have sin like mountains and still you will go to heaven? What is the logic? How does that happen? Like mountains? So even if your sin is 4,000 meter high, still you are going to heaven. And how this will happen? Allah will take the mountain of sin and he put it in someone else. That's amazing. So he could not answer the Abdul because we put him in the corner and we hit him in the nose and all the boogers coming from his nose and he do not know what to do with it. So he put it in his pocket like he's a prophet. And now he came with the idea that you Christians are bad people anyway. And not only that, who is going to pay for the sin of your prophet? Allah gave a license for sin for Muhammad. You believe it? The Muslims, they try to make it like we are the one who be given license for sin when they say Jesus, he paid for your sin, right? Read with me. Chapter 48, verse number 2. ليغفر لك الله ما تقدم من ذنبك وما تأخر. What Allah will do? Allah forgive your past and your coming sin. Do you see it? Open license for sin. So why Muhammad is going to heaven? Based on what Muhammad, he deserved to go to heaven. Obviously, someone is paying for his sin. He have a free pass. Muhammad, he can be a scumbag. He is. Muhammad, he can be gay. He is. Muhammad, he can be a rapist. He is. Muhammad, he wear women clothes. He is. Muhammad, put eyeliner. He is. Muhammad is a child molester. He is. Muhammad, he still underwear. He is. And still he will go to heaven. Why? Because Allah told him something very funny. And actually, if you notice with me in the verse, I don't know if you guys, if you can see with me what I can see. I know some of you, maybe you will not see it, right? Allah saying to Muhammad that may Allah forgive thee. I mean, seriously. Seriously. How stupid the one who made the Quran. To the point he say that Allah may forgive thee. I mean, are you serious? Who is asking may Allah forgive thee? Who is talking here? Hey, who is talking? Come on, come on. Sit the author of the Quran. Sit in my lap, okay? You, obviously, you are a child. And don't worry. I will not do to you what Muhammad did to the children. How you can say that may Allah or Allah may forgive thee? Who's talking? They say to you, Allah. How Allah, he say such a thing? Allah saying that Allah may forgive thee? What is that? Is that a wish? Allah is wishing Allah to forgive to Muhammad sin? What is that? And then he continued with his stupid disaster. That Allah may forgive thee of the sin which in the past and the one to come. Why is that? You know, I understand Allah wanna forgive him for the past, but if you forgive him for the coming one, why? Go, Muhammad, do whatever you want. Muhammad, don't worry about your sin. Muhammad, you can kill, you can do whatever you want, and that's it. You can rape, you can steal, you have an open license for sin. I never heard of a God like this. Who is the one who paid for the sin of Muhammad? How he got the license? I want to get the license like that. I want to go tomorrow to Las Vegas and do all the sin I can do so I can be forgiven like Muhammad. I want to have the same as Muhammad have, the same sandwich, the same deal. Why his past and his coming sin is forgiven? For what? And then you, Abdul, you talk about sin. And then he said to you, in the Facebook that you Christians did not obey Allah and you did not protect the Bible. Which is another stupid story. But just to make it short about Muslims when they say our Bible is corrupt and we are the one who corrupt the Bible. You see, the idea that you can beat God is only exist in Islam. Because if this God is the one who sent the Bible as Muslims they claim, and then we were able to corrupt the book of Allah, that's mean Allah he lost. And that's mean Allah his plan is a shish kebab plan. Anyone can play with it. And that's mean Allah is not almighty. And the funny, the Muslim, they believe in destiny. And destiny mean, according to Islam, the meaning of Islam and destiny is everything is exist, is made to be happened by Allah. Made to be happened by Allah. Which means nothing in this earth, nothing of bad or good, it happened, but it is made a decision before your creation by Allah. And you see that all over the Quran. You know, we can show you tons of verses in the Quran about the destiny. Actually, you can search, if you have my book, The Deception of Allah, you can see I speak about the last chapter of the book about the destiny of Islam, which is proving to you that everything Islam is very stupid, and it's not about being a believer or not being a believer. And this is why I say seriously, Islam is a very stupid religion. I cannot find one kind of any logic in this religion. And this is why when you see a Muslim trying to refute me, like you, and giving me an answer, his answer is very funny and very stupid. And he hit and run. I want to see a Muslim, he want to debate me, and he want to come to me with the answers which he love to give. Can we? Can we find that Muslim? I want to see him. Maybe one day we will see such a Abdul. Maybe one day we will find a Muslim, he have the courage and the knowledge. But my experience with Muslims, the smart one, he don't show up. Because they know their size and they know exactly what will happen to them if they come to debate me. I don't see YouTube in front of me, so the text is not coming. If you guys are texting me, I will try to open YouTube and see if there is any text there in case. However, you know, these days, actually, I have a very, like, I'm happy to see the news. It's coming from Syria as an example. Because the Muslim Mujahideen are losing the fight, big deal, very big deal. And all the screaming and praying to Allah is not working at all. Allah is not there. They made tons of speeches, tons of a prayer, asking Allah for victory. Allah give us victory. And you know, there is no way Allah will make the non-believers have victories over the believers. And guess what? The non-believers, they are victorious. And the Muslims, they have no idea what to do. And all the money of Saudi Arabia and millions of mosques around the world praying for victories of the Muslim terrorists in Syria, it's not working. The same when they pray against Israel, it's not working. And it's not going to work. For your God is a dead God. Funny, the Muslim, they say to us, you Christians worship a dead God when they themselves, they believe that Jesus is alive. And that show you another side of the hypocrisy of those Abdus. There's a Muslim here, he's saying the Christians always worship Paul, just to show you how stupid this Abdul is. Do you know that Paul is mentioned in your Quran, you idiot? And he is, according to your God Allah, he is a messenger of the Messiah, and he is a mighty messenger. Are you there, Abdul? Potato? Huh? What about I give you my Skype right now and you call me in Skype? Do you have the courage? Asban? Let us see. Let us make an examine of the strength. Do you dare to call me right now in Skype? Aban, Asban, whatever your name. Do you dare to call me right now in Skype and debate me? Who is a Muslim exists right now in the chat? He have the guts to call me right now in Skype. Who is the Muslim? He have the courage to call me right now in Skype, right now, not tomorrow. Yes. Look, he stopped moving. Now he played dead. His text is not coming. He's saying, oh no, he's talking to me now. Who is the Muslim? He have the courage to call me right now in Skype. He choose the topic. You choose the topic. Imagine you ask me the question. I'm not going to ask you the question. Who there? Like, how nice that will be. A nice debate. You are the one asking me the question. What do you want more? You choose the question. You choose the topic and we go for it. Who there? So don't be upset when I play for you the anthem of Islam, which is called potato, potato, potato. Do you notice his text is frozen? He's not even texting no more. The guy is dead. Somebody called 911. He's gone. I don't know what happened to him. What happened? His text is not coming. They are like mosquitoes. They don't dare to face you, but they will bite you when you are asleep. You turn the light, they are not there. You turn the light off, they are there. Okay, let me turn the light off. Maybe he will call me then. What do you think, guys? Maybe if I turn the light on, he will do something. Maybe it's a light issue. Maybe. You never know. I mean, like, you never know. Muslims are very sensitive to light. You know, they like darkness. Where is Zakir Naik? You know, Zakir Naik, where is Shabir Ali? The Christian Prince, he did the high leak, and maybe he's a high leak, and, you know, Allah know the truth. So maybe next year we will debate. If your scholars are terrified to talk to me, who are you? Look what he's saying. Where is your source? All the time, all what I said to him about calling me in Skype, he did not get. Now he's asking, where is the source? Source of what? Oh boy. What about you call me right now in Skype, and this is my name in Skype. Do you dare? Do you dare, Abdul? This is my name in Skype. Add me in Skype right now, and I will show you the source. Life, and everybody will see it and read it, and you read it with me. What do you say? Let me give you my Skype name. Are you going to do it? Debate TV. Are you? The stupid Muslims, they attack Paul when their prophet didn't ask themselves a question, a very simple question. How come their prophet, he never said one word about Paul in a bad way? Look like those stupid Paul, the stupid Muslims, they knew about Paul more than their prophet. Their prophet, you do not know. The stupid Abdul, they have knowledge about Paul. They want to expose Paul. But their prophet, he didn't know that Paul, he did anything wrong. Somebody called Muhammad and tell him about Paul because obviously he's a short of information. You see, for 14 centuries, no Muslim speak against Paul until the dad show up on TV and start right away. Muslim, they start copying Paul, Paul, Paul. Nobody ever in the history of Islam spoke a word against Paul. So where they got the story of Paul from? And the Quran speak clearly about the three messengers. And if we go and read the interpretation of the verse, we will see that one of those messengers, the greatest messenger, is Paul. Sometime, you know, there is a video of a monkey in YouTube, in the zoo. The monkey, he flipped upside down and he pissed. And then his piss was coming backward, filling into his mouth, and he drank it. And then I said to myself, what is the difference between this monkey who drank his piss and someone he drank the piss of someone else? In that case, it's an animal. Just because he's a prophet, he told him to drink piss of a camel. If you think about it, Muslims, they are so disgusted because of Paul. But they are not disgusted with drinking piss. I mean, the logic of this Muslims is beyond your imagination. Sometimes you cannot understand it. Sometimes it makes you confused. How in the world that this man Muhammad was able to make those Abduls believe for real that you can drink piss and it's very fine and it is very delicious and they do it and they have no problem with it? Now if we go to Ibn Kathir, let me open Ibn Kathir and show you in the screen. Let me open the page. Ibn Kathir. So this guy, he can read with us what his own scholars say about Paul. Just to show you how dumb those Muslims are, as usual, nothing new. I'm not calling names, by the way. When I say dumb, don't take me wrong. I'm insulting actually the dumb. I'm afraid that someone is dumb, he might sue me because I called the Muslim dumb. It might happen one day. If you go to chapter 36, verse number 14. Verse number 14. And by the way, don't forget in chapter 36, verse number 1, let me go and show you in the screen right now. The same chapter is the chapter speak about Allah's first name, which is Sin. And all of us, we know that Sin is one of the pagan God. His name is Sin. This is why the Christians until now in the West, they say to their children, don't do sin. What does that mean? Where is the word sin coming from? When people before used to worship a god, pagan god, his name is Sin, and the Christianity came, so Christians, they decide to call anything is bad, pagan, a sin from the devil. So they call it sin. So sin really is a word coming from a name of the god, which his name is Sin. And this is one of the names of Allah, Sin. This is why if you go to chapter 36, verse number 1, it says, Ya Sin, Sin, simply, or Sin, is the name of Allah. Ya, in the old Akkadi language, mean God. God, Sin. This God, his name is Sin. And yeah, by the way, in the Bible is used as a word meaning God. Like when you say Yahweh, Yah is God. All right, so Yah-Sin, Yah is not a name. It's not a name. Yah is a word meaning God. So here, if you read with me, this is the chapter 36. Let me make the text bigger so you guys can see it better. I hope it's clear. In this Quran, and this is Ibn Kathir, so Muslim, don't tell me this is my own interpretation or explanation as usual. It says, and we string them with the third. We string them with who? We send two messengers. They accuse them of lying. So we string them with the third. But who are they, those two, and who are the third one? Look what it says. So we went to them, two messengers, they denied them both. Mean they has to disbelieve in them. All right? Then we reinforced them with the third. So the third is the most strong messenger. He is a prophet of God. And he is very powerful, not like the other two who they are weak. Like we got him, we got the best we have. Who is talking now? Supposedly Allah. And then in the narration, in Ibn Jarir, narrated, and etc., Ibn Sulaiman, narrated, etc., 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 the names of the first two messengers were Shamoon, which means Simon, and Yohanna. Yohanna means in Arabic. John, Yohanna is Johan or John, and the third one was Bulos, and this is the name of Paul in Arabic. Paul, Bulos, Bulos. Do you see it, Abdul? Abdul, do you see it in your stupid book, in your scholar's teaching? Paul is the most powerful messenger of God, and yet those stupid Abdul, they insult Paul everywhere they go because they are copy paste nation. Nobody read, nobody educate himself. What do you expect from the stupid except to be stupid, my friend? Do you see it? And then he will say to you, where do you get the real reference from? Where do you get the real reference? Do you have a proof? And this is the reference for those that are seeking reference from Ibn Kathir. Are we clear here? So don't ever again insult Paul, you idiot. Shame on you. When your scholars respect Paul, and they consider him one of the greatest prophets ever. But guess what? In the same page, we have a problem. Anyone knows what the problem? Look what the scholars of Islam, Ibn Kathir, he says about those poor, about those messengers. Unbelievable. I don't know if you can read with me. I hope the screen is clear. Look what it says. That those messengers, they were the messengers of the Messiah, and they were sent to the people of Antakya. Do you see it? But that will make Jesus God, because nobody can make Paul messenger unless God. A messenger cannot make people messenger. If I am a messenger of God, I cannot make a messenger too. But yet they insult Paul all over. I wish I have little of what Paul he has. You Muslim, you have no idea who is Paul. Paul is a great man. Paul was a humble man, not like your scumbag prophet. Paul, to make living, he used to make tents. He don't go and say to people, I will make a miracle for you, even though they did miracles. As you see, even the Quran witnessed that they did miracles. Even the Quran, read the verses, the same chapter we are reading. Those three, they made miracles in the name of Jesus. But look, Paul, he did not ask people to pay him money to make the miracles like your prophet. Your prophet never did miracles, but yet he asked people to pay him in order to pray for them. Just to pray for them and be at their heart. You know, like he, as I said before, he is the same, your prophet is the same as a Pepsi machine, a cola machine. He have a hole in the side. In some scenario, I believe Muhammad, his hole was in the back. You put the coins, and he speak to you as long as coins is running in the hole. But in the case of Paul, he never took a penny to pray to anyone. He sacrificed his life for everyone. He lived as poor, and he died as poor, for he was the man of God. He never get paid gold and silver. He never have a house or a palace. He never owned slaves. He never kidnapped a woman. So how dare you to compare Jesus, you know, Paul to your prophet? How dare you? What a shame. What do you know about Paul? Go study, copy-paste nation. Your copy-paste prophet, he could not even copy-paste the name of Jesus in his Quran correctly. At least, don't be like your prophet. Learn how to copy-paste. Who is the pagan you idiot? Paul, he never kisses stones. Your prophet kisses stones. Paul, he never bowed down in front of a stone. Your prophet bowed down in front of a stone. You Muslims, you follow your prophet. You kiss a stone. You bow down in front of a stone. You walk around a stone and you pray in the direction of a stone. And then when you go there, you walk seven times around the stone. And then you talk about pagans. All your religion is based on stones. If you remember once I told you, I chatted with a Muslim website, it's called Convert to Islam. And I asked the guy there, I have a question, by the way, about Islam. He said, sure. I said, why the prophet kissed the black stone? He said, because it's holy. And I said, why it's holy? He said, because the prophet kissed it. Huh? What? Why the stone is holy? Because why the prophet kissed the stone? Because it's holy. And why it's holy? Because the prophet kissed it. And why the prophet kissed it? Because it's holy. And why it's holy? Because the prophet kissed it. I mean, seriously, how stupid a human being can be. How stupid a human being can be. But what I can say, welcome to the stupidity of Islam. Sometimes it's hard to believe that there's any kind of a human being, he believes in such a garbage. Hard to believe, but there exist. There exist. Yeah, and the God of Islam, he bring you, you know, he promised you ginger. He promised you a drink with ginger in the paradise. Like, can you believe it? Ginger? Ginger in paradise? Can I have carrot juice? Ginger? And he promised me Gucci in the heaven. Anyway, I don't want to change the topic to talk about the promises in paradise because it's very stupid and very weird. Oh boy. Anyway, I want to say, guys, thank you for being here. If anyone have a question, anyone have a question from the text? Please, if you know any Muslim who would like to debate me, you know how to find me, right? We have our donation website for those who want to contact me, or you can contact me in Facebook, or you can contact me in Paltalk. And always we open our chat room in Paltalk, always, always, mostly Friday and Sunday. Now, the coming Friday, just to let you know from now, I have an appointment. It's going to be a little bit late. So if I open up, I will open after I arrive back home. So I'm not sure what time I will be. So it might be late. But usually, always, in Friday, we open. Invite me, I will go. I cannot just go. Come to South Asia, where I will go. You know, you have to invite me. You have to organize something for me. And then trust me, I will go. All right? If people invite me, I will go. I will go and we will drink the drink of heaven together. We will drink ginger. I will come and I will bring 1 pound of ginger with me. So Allah, he can be happy. And you know, to make Allah happy, we can sneeze. You know that Allah, Muhammad, he says, Allah, he loves those who do sneeze. You know the hadith, right? Allah, he loves those who do sneeze and he hates those who do yawning. So one day, I opened a chat room in the Muslim section in Paltalk and I call it, let us sneeze for the sake of Allah. And the Muslim keep coming to the room asking me to close the room. And I say, why? They say the name is offensive. It's offending. I say, why it's offending? He said, because it's not good. I said, why it's not good? This is what your prophet said. Allah loves those who sneeze. Are you saying what your prophet he said is offending? If your God, Allah, he loves sneezing, let us sneeze for Allah. I mean, what's the problem? And until now, nobody can explain to me why Allah, he loves those who sneeze. That's you. I want to know. How Allah get happy and get excited if you sneeze? What is the secret? And I am assuming by this hadith that if you sneeze, if you sneeze, Allah get happy. That means Allah, he get more happy in winter time. You know what I mean? As long we can make him happy by sneezing. So in winter, Allah is so excited. And in you know, like we get cold, we sneeze, we get sick. Allah is happy. Your nose is red. You cannot breathe, but Allah is still happy. You know? Let me see if I can find the hadith. look, guys, look at this hadith, which I found it really funny. I mean, Muhammad is super, super smart. There's a guy who is sitting in the front of the prophet, in the place of the prophet, bees upon him. He sneezes. And then Allah, prophet, he said to him, Allah bless you. Allah have mercy on you. Then he sneezes again. The guy, he sneezes again. And Muhammad, he said to him, Allah have mercy on you. The guy, he sneezed third time. Muhammad, he come to a conclusion. He said, this guy, he have a cold. Unbelievable. I mean, how he knew? I mean, this is astonishing. Look, if this man is not a prophet, how he knew such a thing? The guy, he sneezed, keep sneezing one after one, after one, and then Muhammad, he come to the conclusion, and then they say to you, this is sahih. This hadith is sahih. I mean, do you see how serious the story is? This is alone can be, we can make a show in Discovery Channel about it. The prophet who analyzed the illness of the guy. it must be inspiration from Allah. The guy is sneezing and is sneezing and sneezing, and then the prophet come to a conclusion, this guy obviously he have a cold. Look, the prophet of Allah, he said, this man is suffering from cold. Eesh, eesh. That's deep, man. I mean, how this happened, Dr. Muhammad? I mean, each time I read about you, it's really astonishing. I don't know what to say. I feel like my body is shaking, my friend, with your knowledge. Scary, touchy. That's really weird. All right. Oh boy. Now, some of you, by the way, might say, why Muhammad, he says, may Allah, yarhamukallah, may Allah have mercy on you. But there's a story behind this. Muhammad, he told them that when a person, he sneezes, he dies. All right, and based on this, I did die many times. Unbelievable. Like, you know, I think a few years ago I have a very bad cold, and you can imagine how many times I was dead. Each time you sneeze, you die, and then you come back to life. This is why Muhammad, he told them, when somebody, you hear somebody sneeze, you say to him, may Allah have mercy on you. But the fact he's trying to copy the Jews. The Jews, when somebody sneezes, they say to you, bless you, bless your health, all right, which means may God bless you. Muhammad, he took it wrong. He believed that when you sneeze, you die. So I don't know how many times, if you guys, you die before. Well, I don't know where to come find the hadith. If you are looking for a hadith, you better look for it, because this is why I keep saying, guys, download my videos, save them. One day you will look for them. You won't, you know, I mean, help me. You see all those hadith in front of you on the screen? All of this is about sneezing. We can make ten books about sneezing alone. All of those in front of you, you see, it's about sneezing. Unbelievable. This is why it's very hard to find the hadith about sneezing, you know, the one I want. Too much sneezing will kill you, my friend. Anyway. If anyone have a question? Any Muslim want to call me in Skype? By Jews? By Jews, guys. The Muslim is upset. He said to you, by Jews. Suppose he's insulting you. By Jews. see how stupid the Muslims? They're like kids. He hit the floor with his foot, and he leave the room. He's saying, by Jews. Hey, Jews, bye. You dream to be a Jew. Do you see how smart the Jews and how stupid the Muslims? I mean, go and see how many scientists between the Jews. And go and see how many scientists between all the hundreds of million Muslims. You wish to be a Jew. Actually, Muhammad all his life was trying to play a Jew. But when the Jews, they refuse him, he have no choice. That's why he hate them most. But all his life was trying to play that he is a Jew. He wanted to be a Jew. This is why each time he see a Jew is doing something, he say, do the opposite, don't do what they do. Khalifuhum. Like once, as you see in the front of you, on the screen, there was a funeral. And Muhammad was praying in the funeral for a dead man standing, and then a Jew, a rabbi, he walked by. He said to Muhammad, "This is how we do it." And look what Muhammad did. He said, "Sit down, sit down. Let us do the opposite." Do you see it? Do you see it, guys? Let us do the opposite. That just because the Jew, he said, this is how we do it. Muhammad, he sit down, light up, sit down. Let us do the opposite, okay? Let us do the opposite. Like, what? You have a phobia. Because they keep accusing him that he is trying to copy the Jews. And he is trying to be a Jew. This is why he celebrate a holiday. It's called the Ashura. What is Ashura? Muhammad, he used to fast Ashura. Ask any Muslim. Muhammad fast Ashura. Muhammad love Ashura. Muhammad worship Ashura. Why? What is Ashura? Any Muslim here can answer us? What is Ashura? You see all those hadith in front of you? It's about Ashura. You believe it or not, Muhammad, he have no idea what Ashura. Once he was passing by Jews, and he saw the Jews celebrating, fasting. When they celebrate, mean they fast, they don't dance. So Muhammad, he asked the Jew, "Why you are fasting today?" He said, "Today is the day where Moses, he passed through the sea." Huh? Today is the day where Moses, he passed through the sea. From that day, Muhammad start fasting Ashura. He's trying to be a Jew, obviously. Correct? If this is a fasting for the Jew, why you are... It's not Allah who told him about it. And look at this hadith about here. Muhammad, he says that the one who observe the day of Ashura, huh? The one who observed the fasting of that day, all the sin he did in the previous year is forgiven. Why? Why is that? Or not the Muslims today, they don't fast Ashura no more. Because Muhammad, he fast Ashura, the Jews still don't accept him as a Jew. He thought if he fast Ashura, they will accept him as a Jew. Doesn't work, so he stopped fasting Ashura. Look how important Ashura was. And then when the Jews refuse him to be a Jew, Muhammad, he decide to stop fasting Ashura and he fast Ramadan. Look how many hadith about Ashura. And the Muslims are very confused actually about this day is the day for whom. But let me show you, this is the day for the Jews. Muhammad was walking by the Jews and he learned about it from the Jews. I will try to find it. Maybe later I'll post it for you. Anyway, I think we have enough time today, guys, together. I hope you did enjoy your time. Don't forget to subscribe, please, and share my videos with your friends. And help me so I can help others. When you help me, you are helping others. And how you can help me? Invite me to your church. Share your video. I will go to different countries, and it's all for free. All for free. I don't take wages for what I do. So if you invite me to your church, I don't get paid. All right? I don't. I do it for free. So I'm not like those minister. I'm not a minister, by the way. Some people, they think I'm a minister. I'm a less than all of you. I am a sinner more than all of you. I don't claim to be good, but God. What do is just invite me, and if I ever ask you to pay me for what I do, you can remind me of what I said. I never take or get paid for what I do. So invite me to your church and don't worry about it. And if they ask you how much he charge, tell them zero. Absolutely zero. All right? Let us do something good for the Lord. I hope people will help, and they will be able to organize something. And by the way, you do not need to do it just in a church. You can have, if you have a social club, any kind of things, you know, whatever a kind of organization, because this is a topic important for everybody. Not necessarily even Christians. If you know Hindus, Buddhas, I don't care. Even atheists, I'm willing to go and talk to them. All right? It doesn't matter who they are. But remember, wherever I go, I will be the Christian person. Which means I am not a hypocrite who speak to atheists as an atheist. I will be Christian wherever I go. So I'm willing to talk to everybody, teach everybody, but I will teach as a Christian person. With this, I want to say thank you for being here. May the Lord bless you and keep you in good health and wealth. Until we see you again, Christ is Lord. Islam is false. Amen to that. See ya.